And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek Judgment Rites Blind. I'm the RPG chick, embarking on our next mission, called Voids.
Spock, where do you think we should start looking for this, Brassica?
Logic suggests that they will present us with opportunities to come to them.
Captain, a message from Starfleet.
On screen.
Captain, the USS Regulus has been forced to cancel its survey mission to the Antares Rift. We've decided to redirect the Enterprise to that mission. The USS Hood will take over for your current assignment.
Of course, the Antares Rift has a rather dangerous reputation.
Nothing the Enterprise can't handle. But be careful. Starfleet out.
Does this mean we have a big battle ahead? Alright, before I save, let me check the... We'll see if Spock has anything to say.
The Antares Rift. It should be a most interesting assignment.
How so, Spock?
There have been several attempts to chart it. All expeditions into the Rift vanished without a trace.
But those expeditions were years ago.
Sounds great.
Our starships are far more capable than they were during the time of those attempts.
Captain, a 10-year-old child is far more capable than a 3-year-old child. But there are many problems that neither child can solve.
He's got a point. He definitely has a point. So, let's see. I'm going to check out everything. What about this Brassica? I don't suppose we know anything. Nope. What about Antares Rift? Fifth!
Antares Rift. An area of unstable space near the star Antares. Little is known of its properties. There have been numerous disappearances in this area.
I love Major Barrett's voice. This is the perfect computer voice. Anyway, so unstable space in what way? Physically unstable? Politically unstable? What about this USS Regulus? No. What about the Hood? USS Hood? Nope. Does the computer have anything about Alphans? Or actually Omegans? No. Okay, so I'm actually going to raise shields.
Raising shields.
And I'm going to save the game.
Save new game.
New game. I believe we're up to episode 20. We still have a bit more to go. Alright, so we need to head to the Antares Rift, which is... Let's see... I have an image of this. Whoops. That's not where I want to go. Let me see if I can quickly find this. So yeah, this is your old style copy protection. As opposed to on disk. I noticed the music, the sounds just went away. Okay. I know I have it. Here it is. Okay, so we want to go to Antares Rift, which is... Sorry, I was like not really ready for this. It's number 15. Which is, I believe, here? That's a rift. Alright. It is not even a star. It's a... Yeah, it looks like a nebula or something. Hope it's the right place. Engage. Cool.
Captain's log, stardate 6257.6. We have entered the Antares Rift and found spatial disruptions in the rift that make using warp engines extremely dangerous.
Oops.
Repairs are almost complete on the minor damage we suffered upon entry into the rift.
Damage?
We are continuing our survey using impulse engines.
My poor babies. Warp engines were meant to be used, Captain.
Communications are back online, Captain.
Deflectors at 93% power and increasing.
Captain, undoubtedly, that phenomenon would explain many of the strange disappearances in this sector. still with our warp engines deactivated. Our computers indicate we will be safe.
Yeah, until we hit by freaking space lightning.
Communications are out again, Captain. Frontal is anyone view. Hurt?
If he was human, Mr. Spock's pride might be...
Captain, sensors failed to indicate anything unusual prior to the explosion. I would speculate that it was caused by an extremely unusual rift in the space-time continuum.
Saving face.
A place where radically different physical laws apply.
As this was different space-time, our sensors weren't programmed to detect it.
And it could happen again at any time without warning.
Right, Mr. Chekhov. I love these accents. I love Mr. Sulu's accent. George Takei, I believe it's pronounced. Space-time. Alright. Well. Alright, so I'm walking around the ship. Okay. Interesting. Okay, can I just talk to anybody? That would be awesome. I'm gonna talk to this red shirt guy over here. Well, let's just look at everybody first, actually.
Ensign Walker came to the bridge to discuss discrepancies in the last damage control report. He now wishes he was elsewhere.
I'm set loose on the bridge. This is awesome.
Mr. Scott wonders how he'll look like a miracle worker this time.
We never had this before.
This is the second time that hailing frequencies have gone down today. Lieutenant Uhura is not having a good day.
Yeah. Yeah, we want that crap up, don't we?
Mr. Spock is trying to determine a way to detect the rifts before the Enterprise is destroyed.
That would be a really good idea.
Mr. Chekhov sometimes wishes he had a safer occupation, like handling antimatter.
Actually, I never would have guessed that was Mr. Chekhov if I wasn't aware of the show and that he just spoke.
Mr. Sulu has complete faith in his captain, who has gotten them out of worse predicaments than this.
True that.
James Kirk worries about the safety of his ship.
Can I look at all the stuff?
This is where Kirk sits. The captain's log is stored here, as well as a record of landing party assignments.
Yeah, that's right. Can I check out the captain's log?
This is the ship's navigation station. This is Chekhov's pride and joy, allowing him to enter the ship's headings and to prepare the weapons in the Enterprise's, fortunately few, space battles.
You got that right.
This is the ship's helm station. From here, the helmsman can control the ship's shields and its orbital heading.
What about middle?
This seems pointless.
Oh, look at the middle is pointless. Empty chair?
This seems pointless.
Empty chair is pointless.
Mr. Scott's home away from home, aka engineering. This allows access to some of the more important engineering functions from the bridge. Most notably, damage control systems and emergency power and internal sensors. The damage readout for the Enterprise has gone crazy.
Really?
There are obviously problems with the ship's damage registers.
Well, that's no good.
Mr. Scott's home away from the communications station. This is where Lieutenant Uhura is normally located.
Normally?
This door leads to the turbo lift. Ship's short-range sensor display for the science station. Now all it is displaying is static.
Well, Spock must love that.
Ship's long-range... This is the science station, where Spock scans anomalies and operates the ship's library computer.
How about this side?
This seems pointless.
Over there is pointless. Okay. This is the floor?
This seems pointless.
That's pointless.
Ideas, Mr. Walker?
I'm a security guard, sir, not an idea man. Still, if we could send out probes to detect these rifts, we might get a better idea on whether they're moving or not, and whether we should stop and make repairs or keep moving.
Seems you do have some ideas.
Scotty, what's our status?
Very bad, Captain. Whatever hit the Enterprise hit us right in our own neighborhood. The hull is breached 6 meters from the bridge. Beyond that, the instruments are useless.
Not good.
I can't read or send anything through these controls. We'll need a starbase to make this bridge functional again.
Scotty, how about auxiliary control?
Captain, I cannot determine the status of anything beyond the place where the rupture occurred. The rest of the ship could be dead as far as we know.
Status, Mr. Sulu.
Helm is not responding, Captain. The controls are completely dead.
That's not good.
Status, Mr. Chekhov.
Captain, navigation is not responding. The circuits are as lifeless as a Stalinist.
Of course, Russian reference.
Any ideas, Lieutenant?
I was barely able to reroute the necessary connections last time, Captain. Communications are completely useless now. We may be able to enter codes into the library computer and instruct others to send messages to us.
Captain, I believe I may be able to adjust the sensors to detect these spatial rifts and pilot the Enterprise to avoid them. However, the sensors are too heavily damaged here. I will need to get to auxiliary control as soon as possible if I am to reroute the necessary systems.
Mr. Spock, the bulkheads were breached just outside of the bridge. No one's going to be able to leave the bridge for at least an hour unless they're transported out.
No one's. All right. What did he say at the end again? I was too distracted by no one's.
Captain, I believe I may be able to adjust the sensors to detect these spatial rifts and pilot the Enterprise to avoid them.
All right, so we need to get
However,
to auxiliary control.
However, the sensors are too heavily damaged here.
Mr. Spock, the bulkheads were breached just outside of the bridge. No one's going to be able to leave the bridge for at least an hour unless they're transported out.
So we need to transport ourselves out then. Obviously.
Save new game. Replace previous.
I can't just walk this way?
It's stuck. We're not getting out of here that way.
Everyone abandoned their posts. Do they have anything new to say?
Ideas, Mr. Walker?
I'm a security guard.
Scotty, what's our status?
Very bad, Captain. Whatever hit the Enterprise hit us right in our own neighborhood.
Scotty, how about auxiliary control?
Captain.
Let's see. Can we... I want to check out Captain's log.
Captain's log, supplemental. Things are a complete mess on the bridge, with little immediate hope for improvement.
I was hoping we could access past logs.
Captain's log, supplemental.
Guess not.
Captain's log.
Captain, these controls are useless.
Nah.
Captain. Captain, I have to fix that in engineering when I get a chance to get off the bridge.
Okay.
Captain, I've already said they're useless. I might be able to employ backup systems from auxiliary control.
Well, let's fly this out of here.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Captain, I am quite capable of doing my job.
I'll take over from here, Mr. Spock. So now we can command all these people.
Captain, these controls are useless.
So what if we order, like, Scotty to do stuff like this?
I can make my own log entries, thank you.
I don't understand what you want me to do, Captain.
Captain, I've already said they're useless.
Captain, I am quite capable.
There's quite a bit of stuff we can do here. What if we have Uhura?
I can make my own log entries, thank you.
Captain, these controls are useless.
Captain, I am quite capable of doing my job.
Trying to get some more lines out of Uhura.
Captain, things look very bad. I can't get any of the controls to respond.
That's not Uhura.
Helm still does not respond, sir.
Captain, I've already said they're useless.
There is no problem with the display, Captain. We have been cut off from ship sensors.
Captain, I have to fix that.
Right. Where is, who's this? Is that Sulu?
Captain, I have to fix... Captain.
I just want to try out different combinations.
Helm still does not...
Well, it doesn't seem to really work.
Captain, I've already...
Captain, I am...
Okay. So we have to teleport there. How do we do that? That's usually something you select through Kirk.
Captain, I have to fix...
Captain's log, supplemental.
Already with the puzzle here. Well, seems like when you choose Spock, everything turns out alright somehow.
I can make my own log.
Captain, things look...
Helm still...
Alright, there he goes. Spock can
Captain,
do anything!
The library computer is online. Apparently, its circuits were shielded from the explosion. Captain, I have managed to program a message into the library computer.
See what I mean?
The first time a person accesses the computer, they will read our distress signal. Hopefully, they can code a reply into the computer, which we can access.
Okay.
Captain, I've already said there...
What now, then?
Captain, I believe I may be able to adjust the sensor,
Mr. Spock.
Can Spock do anything else?
Captain, I've already...
Captain, the transporters are operational. I request permission to be transported, so I can begin the adjustments to sensors as soon as possible.
Go ahead, Spock.
Yes.
No, Spock, I'll go first. Go ahead, Spock.
Go ahead, Spock. Why not?
Oh, Spock.
That was different. What the hell? I saw that. Did anyone else see that?
Captain, this bridge is useless. For our own sake, as well as Spock's, we have to find a way to get out of here.
The controls are still not functioning, Captain.
Captain, what was that thing?
I don't know, Mr. Jackoff, but I intend to find out.
Right.
Captain, we need to get off the bridge. I recommend we keep monitoring the science station and see if anyone answers our messages.
Okay.
Captain, that thing with the four arms wasn't... Mr. Spock, was it?
No.
That beam wasn't some sort of transmutation beam, was it?
I don't think so, Mr. Walker. But the two have to be connected.
Right.
Spock, what happened to him?
James Kirk worries about... Mr. Scott wonders how he'll look like a miracle worker this time.
Nah.
Mr. Sulu has complete faith in it. Mr. Chekhov sometimes wishes he had a safer occupation, like handling antimatter. This is the second time that hailing frequent. Ensign Walker came to the bridge to discuss
Okay, so we should monitor.
I can take care of that, Captain.
All right, Mr. Sulu. Get down with your bad self.
I'm patching your log into the computer. You should have voice messages.
Oh, goody.
Captain, we've managed to jury-rig an evacuation tube through the bridge turbo lift. We should be able to keep it stable long enough for you to be evacuated.
Oh, cool. Sounds good to me. What do you think, Sulu?
The controls are still not functioning, Captain.
Any more messages while you're there?
I'm patching your log into the computer. You should have voice messages.
Captain, we've managed to jury-rig an event.
Okay, so not voice messages, but voice message.
Captain, this bridge is...
Captain, what...
I don't know, Mr. Jackoff.
Okay, does that mean we can just waltz through the door here?
Save new game. Replace...
All aboard. Hurry up, Sulu. Oh, nice. I remember this from the end of the first game. Inaccessible. Inaccessible. Accessible. So, nice. What if I click something like this? Doesn't work, right? Only these. So only Turbo Lift 1 is damaged. I don't know which one 1 is. So we're already in the bridge, obviously. Obviously we're going to auxiliary control at some point, but I really want to go to sickbay and stuff. We get to look around the Enterprise. Freaking awesome.
Captain's log. After equipping ourselves with tricorders and phasers, we are now searching for a way to find Spock and return him to us. I've determined that the best place to start...
Captain, it's a very good thing we took the warp engines offline.
How bad is it, Scotty?
That explosion was 42% stronger than the one that struck near the bridge. Our lift warp nacelle is crippled, Captain.
I hope it's not a trend. Keep me posted, Mr. Scott. Kirk out.
Huh. Yeah, I hope we're not on some kind of time limit here.
Captain James T. Kirk.
Correct.
Ensign Pavel Chekov.
Yes.
Lieutenant Hikaru Sulu. Ensign Angus Walker.
Where's her? I figured we were all going.
The sick bay status indicator shows that everything is normal. This passage leads back to the turbo lift. A ship's communications panel. Sick bay emergency door controls.
Oh, we got to use that?
Sick bay emergency door controls.
What about this thing?
Sick bay life support warning panel.
What about this?
The wall of the corridor outside the Enterprise's sick bay.
Oh, the wall. What's this?
The floor of the corridor outside the Enterprise's sick bay.
That's a floor.
The wall of the corridor.
All right. What sayest thou, gentlemen?
El Sulu? When the Enterprise is in trouble, who do they turn to save the day?
And guess who doesn't get the glory?
Or the credit.
Yes, let's not forget the credit.
Stop complaining, gentlemen. And I thought McCoy was a major league grouser.
Yeah, really? Where the hell is McCoy? Well, I guess he's in sick bay.
Don't worry, Captain. If we can't get Spock back, I wouldn't be surprised if he got himself out of this mess.
I'd like to think so, but I fear there are limits even to Spock's abilities.
Yeah.
Losing Spock is like losing my right arm.
I know. I can do almost anything.
Sick bay. I hate sick bay. Why do we have to come here?
Random chance, really.
We don't have time to waste. No, I don't think that's necessary.
So we still have...
Maybe I should leave the tricorder to my science officer.
You don't have one.
Maybe I should leave the tricorder to my science officer.
You mean medical officer?
The communicator looks fine to me.
I actually meant to use it, but...
Captain, why do you need the med kit?
I don't know why you need a med kit, Captain. Hello, Bones.
Well, Jim, I leave you alone for 5 minutes and look at the mess you've made.
I know.
Dr. McCoy, who never understood why people get so nervous in sick bay. It's the safest part of the ship.
True.
James Kirk, captain of the Enterprise, who never really liked sick bay.
Oh, well.
Hikaru Sulu, doing his best to remain calm in a difficult situation. Pavel Chekov, who still has nightmares about the time in sick bay when they conducted close to 50 tests on him, when the others in his landing party were hit by advanced aging and he wasn't.
Ooh. Wonder if I've seen that episode.
Angus Walker, who remembers being in a hospital when he was a child on Earth. Assorted medicines are stacked on shelves behind an enclosure.
They sure are.
Assorted medicines are... Lighting controls for sick bay. Medical instruments line the wall of sick bay. This device monitors a patient's condition. It is currently inactive. This device This bed is currently unoccupied.
As is this one.
This bed is This seems pointless. This seems pointless.
The wall.
This seems pointless.
Well, Bones, it looks like we have to save Spock in order to save the Enterprise.
That's a tough choice, Jim.
Oh, God. You love Spock, and you know it.
If we keep having these random explosions, Doctor, I'm afraid your sick bay is going to be overflowing.
I thought you were a helmsman, not the bearer of bad tidings.
I do many things well, Doctor.
That you do, Mr. Sulu.
Hello, Doctor. Nice weather, isn't it?
You're a navigator, not a conversationalist, Ensign.
Yes, I am. And an unappreciated navigator at that.
So crabby today, Bones.
Don't worry, Doctor. I'm all right. You don't need to treat me.
Then why are you here?
I'm just with the captain. I'm feeling great. You don't have to...
That's fine, Lieutenant.
What a bedside manner.
You get no response.
I didn't mean to talk to that.
Medical instruments line the...
Right, we saw that, right. Okay, oh yeah, what's this?
This equipment allows Dr. McCoy to quickly synthesize chemicals and save his patients' lives.
Hmm.
Jim, what's going on? I've had smoother eyes than the Starfleet Vertigo test wheel.
Hmm. Do we have him do stuff?
I don't understand any of this, Jim.
All right, we'll go sleepy.
I don't understand any of this, Jim. I don't under...
All right, right. You don't understand stuff. Well, I guess there's really nothing to do here, at least at this point. Since we didn't actually leave, can I get
Leave my equipment alone. If things don't improve, I'll be needing it soon.
Hmm.
I would appreciate it if you left my equipment alone.
Eh.
I would appreciate...
No, I don't think that's necessary.
All right, let's go. We gotta leave his equipment alone. Yeah, I was like, why aren't we leaving? All right, now what if I go further down this way? There's another turbo lift there, isn't there? No. Oh, okay. What about this side of sick bay? Same. All right. Can I go to engineering? Cool.
Captain, there has been an explosion near the shuttle bay. I'm fine. There has been no significant damage.
Any luck communicating with Starfleet Command?
I have made contact with the light cruiser USS Jefferson, sir. Hmm. It will reach the edge of Antares Rift in 16 hours. The Rift is playing havoc with communications.
Thank you, Lieutenant Kirkout.
Why are we here again? Some random survey? Doesn't seem worth it.
This panel gives emergency access to engineering for authorized personnel. Since access to engineering has not been shut down, this panel is not active.
Got to remember that.
This board is a summary of the ship's engineering status, so that Mr. Scott and the other engineers will have necessary information before they enter engineering. The hull integrity status looks dangerously low.
Not good.
This seems pointless.
Well, they look like waffles. I was hungry.
This is the doorway to main engineering. This seems The force field generator containment controls, used to prevent intruders from getting to engineering. They are not functioning.
I don't want those to be functioning.
This seems pointless.
What about these little things?
The interior temperature is currently 24.1 degrees Celsius. A little warm for your taste.
Warm in here, huh?
Atmosphere is at 93.8%, well within safety standards.
Vent?
This seems pointless.
All right.
Pavel Chekhov, doing his best to be optimistic in a difficult situation. Jim Kirk, as usual, bearing all the burdens of his vessel. Hikaru Sulu, full of faith and determination.
Yeah, go Sulu.
Angus Walker, going where no security guard has gone before.
Right.
This is not one of my better days.
Captain, if we get out of this alive, can we have shore leave?
Well, you hear what Mr. Scott said about us needing to go to a starbase.
Actually, Captain, I had something a bit larger in mind.
Chekhov lives for shore leave.
I do not. Well, maybe a little bit.
Maybe a little bit. Oops, stuck there for that.
There's an awful lot of corridors on the Enterprise.
You get no response.
I didn't aim that
Captain,
right.
Do you think we'll get out of this alive?
I really don't know.
That doesn't give me much confidence. Really, Captain, do you think we'll get out of this alive?
Are you trying to suggest we won't? Will I have to put you on report for threatening morale?
Thank you, sir.
Oh my god. We've got another smart-ass, wise-cracking ensign here. We will not put up with this insubordination.
Save new game.
Let's make a new game. For all I know, we have to go to these sections in a certain order or in a certain amount of time. Can I do anything with any of this stuff?
If we want to fix these controls, we'll have to get into the Jeffries tube. And if my tricorder's correct, we'll have to seal a hull breach first. We'd probably need to get to a starbase to repair this.
Captain, I know we want to prevent the alien from entering engineering, but from what we saw, I don't think a locked door will stop it.
Chekhov's right, Captain. And we don't want to restrict access to engineering in an emergency.
True.
Atmosphere at 93.8% optimal. At least we won't suffocate soon.
Mm-hmm.
24.1 degrees Celsius. I knew it was getting warm in here. I don't like the looks of this hull integrity indicator.
We don't like the looks of anything around here. Let's go inside.